Welcome to day three of Rocky Mountain Race Week. We're headed to Noble, Oklahoma. Doug Noble's ready to go. Here at the whole Cleater Camp is ready to rock and roll, so we're going to hit the road today, and the Marquis is just always ready to go. So we're going to hop in and head out now. Chad, you ready for this long drive in this thing?
No.
Let's do it.
Ready to go. Get editing, you know.
Oh, we got to get on that edit mode down the road.
Hanging out of that window, getting some
This is the motion media Marquis this week.
Stickers.
We definitely need some stickers. All right, guys. So we're gonna go. When we get there, I'm actually gonna try to do some Google and figure out if there's an ABS sensor on this thing to possibly bypass. If not, we might be in luck, and somebody might have a tuner near Great Bend, which doesn't really help us out for tonight. But ultimate goal, 1299 by the end of the week. So if it takes getting a tuner there, maybe some bigger jets by the time we get back to Tulsa, we're gonna try everything we can to get this thing in the 12s this week. Hey guys, made it to the first gas stop, I guess, today. Already been rolling for a few hours. Looks like we got about another three to go. Chad's been editing away, getting some photos. Ooh, hey, Doug's Nova made it. Easy peasy. Everybody's making a good trip so far. No problem. How's this thing doing on fuel? Pretty good?
15 miles of gas.
Not bad.
Pulling the trailer, I'm pretty satisfied with it.
Just enough power when you need it.
I mean, we could probably... It's kind of going down the road a little rich, and it doesn't have a whole lot of time, and we could probably stretch it, but I don't
want it. It's good. It's happy.
Yeah.
Doug's office for the week. Full interior streetcar. Today, it's Casey's Pizza and a cream soda Dr. Pepper, and Chad's got Sammy.
Turkey!
Oh, boy, and James has got some cookie dough. Dang. Look at that. Making our way through the 326-mile route, getting ready to come up on our checkpoint here, get our picture, and keep going on the road. It's already getting a little bit later, so trying to make some good time to kind of get caught back up. Quick little stop, Chad.
Oh, yeah, a little quick stop.
So Cletus threw a belt on the Corvette. We went back, tried to find it. Couldn't see it. I think it might have came off quite a ways back, but... Otherwise, he's back up and running. Now they're looking at some stuff up here. Try to get back on the road. Spotted the checkpoint. It's actually right there. You guys might not be able to see it because of the tree, but pulling up now. Chad's still getting down on his video. Oh yeah,
in there.
And there it is. So my intuition on the speedometer might be a little wrong, but I still don't know how we're maxing out at 99 every single pass. But rolling down the road right here, 72 miles an hour, 73, and we're at 73, 74 right there. So I really am not sure. It looks like the speedometer's really not even that far off. So who knows, or maybe that's a little off, but the vehicle speed for what tells the computer is a little different. I'm not quite sure. So we actually almost need to test this and see if we actually hit a speed limiter. And then we'll know for sure if this thing, where it like limits out, at least based on the tack, or I haven't really watched it going down the track at all, so I don't know, trying to figure it out. So after some scientific research, everything seems on and doesn't seem to be hitting a limiter. All right, guys, we are super close to the track. Decided to make a quick run by the auto parts store, see if we can get some plugs, because I'm pretty sure, I know we've never looked at the plugs. These might be stock 100,000-mile plugs on this thing. Thinking if we can get one step cooler, tighten up the gap, maybe that'll help us out, since maybe the speed limiter isn't our issue. So we're gonna go ahead and do that, and then see you guys at the track. We just got to the track, getting Wally prepped in the mode, getting all our stuff unloaded. We gotta get tires on this thing. So there is a little bit of a storm, if you guys kind of see it. Hopefully it doesn't roll in here, but just in case, we're just gonna run up there, make a hit so we get a good slip, and then if we have time, put plugs in it and make another one. If not, we'll have plugs for tomorrow, but kind of under the gun, a little late today. So we're gonna just try to do what we can to make sure we get a good hit in. Down on a little power. Something a little bit slower than probably what they were hoping for. But we'll go back, we'll look at the log, we'll figure it out, and I'm sure be back up here. All right, we're set up for our first pass here at Thunder Valley Noble after a about 5 hour, I would say, drive, 320 whatever miles. It's hot, it's humid. We haven't done anything to Wally. If we got enough time, we're gonna put some plugs in it, but otherwise we're gonna send him and see what happens here and then go from there. That's how Wally did in the heat of the day. Thank you. 13:42, so slow down a little bit, but real consistent. 99.7 miles an hour. Just, it's gonna do 99.7 no matter what. So I guess what we're gonna do is try to get some plugs in this thing and then try that again. So 13:42 with a 7.99, 189 60 foot. So I think it actually picked up a little bit in the 60 foot here. Maybe let it cool down and then play with the plugs and just see if that does anything. Otherwise we gotta try to figure out something. It might just come down to the last day of trying to spray the house down on this thing and seeing if we can get it to go a little quicker. If that's the case, I gotta find some more jets to try to up the shot, and then who knows how much fuel we got too. So we might be up against a few things here. I was hoping it was speed limiter. I'm not thinking that it is so much anymore. All right, Doug, so 8:30, not quite exactly what you wanted.
We're on one turbo.
One turbo, huh? Yeah.
Wastegate came off, the clamp came loose, probably just the vibration driving on the road.
A lot of miles today.
I heard partway through the, probably like after the 60 foot, I heard a little bit of a hiss, so I thought it was kind of weird, but I was looking down, everything was good, and it just was a turd.
It sounded so lazy, like mid track.
That's when it started running on one turbo, yeah. And it just shot a fireball out of the where the wastegate would normally connect, melted the CO2 lines.
Sheet.
So it went 830, 166, so. But
on one turbo.
We fixed it, and we know that it'll front half on that. And so we should be able to go up and get a 7 second pass quick.
Nice.
And then hopefully wait for the sun to go down and
get after it a little bit more.
See if we can't get after it a little bit more. We can keep wastegates on the piping.
Yeah. It's a struggle.
That is the weird thing about driving, coming to the track and switching stuff out. Like normally you'd go home, you know, after driving it or racing it and check everything over. And it's just so fast paced that can't catch everything, even if you do nut and bolt it. It's just like,
yeah, you did what? Probably a 5+ hour drive today, and within an hour, yeah, had the car switched over and making a pass.
Yeah, we were running hard to get here. We were way behind. We started too late, and then we had a bunch of, you know, we helped a bunch of people on the road, so it was just one of those things. This is what race week's all
this
about.
This is what race week is.
You gotta roll with the punches.
Heck yeah. Well, see how this next one goes. There we go. So 788, I think he was hoping to go a little deeper than that, but that's still, it's deeper than he's been, I think, all week. So really killer pass. I'm sure he'll be happy with it. I don't know if they'll try to go a little bit further than that or not. Find out here in a minute. 88. Look good up here. Yep. Good mile an hour. I mean, kind of the same.
177.
Not real crazy up top.
We didn't change anything up top. We just got after
a little. Nice. How was the 60 then?
Baby steps. It knocked almost 200, so 60.
Heck yeah. Trying to race the sun before it goes down, but got 5 plugs out so far. That's kind of what we're looking at. Getting some new ones in it. Big Ford fan right now. Not really. That kind of sucks, but undo the little bolt here. Pop the coil out. Get the plug out from down there. Try not to drop a bunch of shit in there. Throw some new plugs in it and go real, real fast. That's the plan. All right. Gonna get back to it. New plugs are in it. See how it runs. Ooh, fires right up. How much horsepower do them glasses add? Dang, doubled up, 2 mullets, and a shaved ice truck. Woo! Gosh, dang. All right. Just don't let them get the tree on you, though.
We're going to let him roll around.
You can chase him down, give him no excuses.
If it falls apart, we can drive around the park.
What's this unit got for a power plant?
The Eco Boost motor, I think.
Oh, yeah?
So it probably runs pretty okay.
Might not be too bad. So we got the ice cream truck versus cone ice truck. Lots of freedom sitting in that one. What do you got, Matt? Which one? Which one you got? Who you got?
I gotta go with the snow cone truck.
All right, yeah.
I think it might have a little more power than the ice cream.
A little more modern technology. Yeah, I get it.
Got music.
I mean, and the guys are wearing Vipers. I mean, and mullets. Lots of horsepower right there. Real big burnout truck.
Roll that beautiful bean footage.
Come on, baby. Come on. Well, lots of weight. See if Tom can get them spinning here. Good old shootout here. Here goes the match. Oh! Gonna try to drive around him. Try to go around him on the top side. Here it goes. Yeah! 1898. To a 22.
Robert Williams.
Let's go, man. Let's do this.
He forced my hand, so
yep.
We got to make an effort here.
This is part of the deal.
Yep.
All right. Good luck. All right, here we go. Fresh plugs are in it. Bottle's ready to go. See if we can set a new personal best in Wally. The track's there. Just if the altitude and the new plugs helped out, maybe we can get what we need. There we go, boys, purged out, ready to rip. Pretty good. I wasn't watching the tack, so I guess we'll see what happens. But good job, Wally. Hopefully we got a good slip on that one. Felt good. Definitely felt good. Felt like the best 60 foot we've had all week. Thank you.
Thanks, sir.
So 1343. 98. It actually fell off on mile an hour right there, but it went a better 60 foot. 1343. Dang it. Same exact time as earlier. Well, not quite what you're looking for.
Yeah, didn't really respond. I looked down, we added a couple more pounds of boost, and it was pretty fat on the left and right bank.
Oh.
Actually, more the left, I think, than the right, but definitely picked up a bunch down low, but didn't really do anything out back with it. So we're going to look at the chance. There's something not quite right about the car this week. I've felt it all week. It doesn't run quite like it normally does.
Not as crisp. It's there, but it's just not.
It's close, but there's something. I just got to figure out what it is.
Yep.
We still want 782.
Dude, I mean, that's what, the 4 7-second pass this week?
Yeah.
Either way, it's...
No, we've done 3 today.
Oh, yeah. Fifth. Yeah. Yeah.
It's doing what I really wanted to set out to do. I just want to be a little closer to
it. And then this is when the competitive mode kicks in. And
then I just want to wring its neck.
All right, got our bags. Long day, Chad.
Long day.
So, Wally didn't go any quicker, but we got some Taco Bell. Here you go eat.
Yeah, I'm hungry.
All right, me too. We're hungry, we're tired, we got a long drive ahead of us tomorrow. So we will see you guys in the next video. Please hit that like, subscribe, and share button. See you next time.